executive director, my name is Williams, but just a few words first. I'd really like to thank HEC staff for really stepping up to the plate. They're always the ones who do all this. As always, I'm the one wearing black. You can complain to me, but they do all the work. Nadesh has done a terrific job as deputy director under very, very extreme circumstances. Michelle Arbelou, who all of you get emails from and has been also keeping the office running. Barbara Zay, who has been representing us at HTC very capably. Bridget Harmon, who managed all of these details. This is her first Grassroots Awards. And last but not least, Kelly Carroll, who is joining us and who will be contacting all of the community groups that we have the pleasure of working with. If you've not heard from her by Friday, you have my permission to call, introduce yourselves, and tell her your complaints. We're keeping a new record of complaints with which we can then present to the new Landmarks Chair in July when she starts. Recently, I had the misfortune of having to take some forced time inside. And while I was there, I was thinking about the neighborhoods and the people who sustain them. And let me just say that upon leaving Durham's Vile, one of the best things in the world is to actually go out into New York to see the buildings, to see the neighborhoods, to see the stewardship that people in our communities give to our historic neighborhoods and give to our homes and make these places real. That's what New York is about, and all of you are what enable us to do this and to sustain it. We are New York, and I thank you all for it. Thank you.
I just want to spend a few seconds talking about a little bit more about what we do. As you all know, we advocate and we educate. On the line of advocacy, you all know our 6 to Celebrate program, which is now in its 4th year, and it's very successful. And so what we do is that we nurture fledgling organizations. I see people in Europe who wear some of our 6 to Celebrate. This year, one of our 6 to Celebrate is the campaign to save the economy libraries. And this is a really topical issue, as you know, since the libraries are underfunded and we may have dodged a bullet on the library that we may not have dodged a bullet. And I think it's important to keep the issue of the libraries on the front burner. And so the campaign to save the economy libraries is one of our 6 to Celebrate. In the education sort of sphere, we've started some new initiatives this year. We've started a new, and the only actually, design awards, preservation design awards program that recognizes new and intelligent and sensitive designs with affecting historic buildings. We had our first pop of projects a couple of months ago, and they were really extraordinarily thoughtful and intelligent, and it was really interesting to hear the architects talk about them without having talked to each other before. Essentially, they were all dealing with the issue of memory, which is what we are always kind of doing. We've also inaugurated just a couple of weeks ago a new thing, which is a new early summer talk, which is webbing student thesis presentations. It occurred to us that every year, graduate students graduate at a preservation graduate program, so with a master's degree in preservation, and they do theses. And these theses represent often new thinking, a tremendous amount of research, a tremendous amount of intelligence, and often sort of new roles and new kind of facets of the preservation movement. And the students do these theses, and they just kind of disappear, you know, and nobody knows about it. They don't reach the public. And we thought that HTC would be the ideal forum for the best thesis to be presented to members of the public. And we had this event 2 weeks ago. It was free. It was very well attended, and was enjoyed not only by the public but also by the students who actually got to communicate their ideas to a broader world. So that was very successful. And we continue our professional education program, which all architects up there give you continuing education, billet credits. And our next one is in a couple of weeks, in the morning, it's about terracotta. So we're going to have Susan Twinning speaking there, and Dan Allen, who's an expert on terracotta, Harold Kendall from the KSK, so it could be a very rich program. And lastly, but not least, we've revamped our website, which you should really all become very familiar with. A friend of mine said today to me by email, he said, HTC's website is fantastic, it's the best. And it really is very, very good. So I hope you will be familiar with it, and I hope that you look at it tonight and come to our next event. And this is my last note. Come to our next event, which is Wednesday next week. Which is titled Battle of Brooklyn. And it's going to be at the Lyceum in Brooklyn. And this is the thing about which Simon was quoted today in the New York Times by my chairman. Mm-hmm. So I will say no more. The poster, which is really terrific, is pink. And that's all I want to say about it. And you should go and look at it, and certainly you should attend. So that is all I would say about HTC. We are very vibrant, and we are very active, and we always vibrant to the staff, but also to the board, which is a very active board, and the ideas that we have and the dynamism that we have, we really owe it to that wonderful combination of a super talented staff and a very engaged board. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Pentecost. We will start now with our awards. And first to present will be Dr. Jeffrey Pressman.
I am honored and a bit awed to be presenting this Grassroots Preservation Award to Michael Perlman. Because of all of the awardees we could think of, no one better represents a grassroots preservationist better than Michael. Because nothing motivated him other than, gee, our neighborhood is historic. Isn't it beautiful? I'm sorry I'm speaking in simple declarative sentences, but sometimes people who don't like preservation don't understand. So I'm speaking simply. It's remarkable that in 2006, he founded his own organization. Now, 20 years ago, thank you, Jack Taylor, all we would have done would be to print out a letterhead. And voila, we have an organization. Michael did the same thing, only he did it with a blog and with a Facebook page and garnered enormous awareness of the historic resources in Forest Hills and Rego Park. Now, I was recently at an event where Professor Kenneth T. Jackson of Columbia said, it really doesn't matter whether the actual building where the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory fire was, as long as we know that the event took place and we can walk by, well, the building used to be here. And I submit that that line of thinking is antithetical to what makes a healthy city. And it's the opposition to that kind of thinking that motivated Michael. You'll notice this photograph of Michael in the program. He's standing in front of the Midway Theater. Does it matter if this actual building is still there? Does it matter that the theater was named after the Battle of Midway and not because it's in the middle of Queens? Lastly, I can't believe Michael pulled this off. A couple of years ago, only 3 years ago, the Westside Tennis Club in Forest Hills, when you say tennis, Forest Hills, it's actually the Westside Tennis Club, private club, thought their tennis stadium was old and decrepit, and really it is old and decrepit, but it's historic. And when I heard that they were planning to sell it for real estate development, I said, sayonara. There's no hope for this building because it's private property, they have zoning rights, and it's Queens. The punchline is, the tennis stadium is still there, and it matters that the tennis stadium is still there. It's not enough to say, hey, that's Forest Hills. That's where Bill Tilden played in the 1920s. No, we want to be able to see the actual tennis stadium where Bill Tilden played in the 1920s. It's not enough to say, you know, in the 1960s, there were a lot of concerts there. The Monkees played there in 1967. Do you know who opened for the Monkees in 1967? Jimi Hendrix. I can't make that up. The idea, by the way, everyone said, we want the Monkees. Jimmy smashed his guitar on the stage and stormed off. Anyway, because of Michael's work, we have a live preservation voice in Queens, someone who is passionate about his local landmarks and makes it known that they're not just local landmarks, they matter to all of us in the city. So on behalf of the Historic Districts Council, I want to thank Michael Perlman and to present him a Grassroots Preservation Award.
Good evening, everyone. I am a 31-year-old native Parsons resident and chairman of Rego-Forest Conservation Council. I feel honored to receive the 2014 Grassroots Conservation Award. I'm also encouraged to become an even stronger historic preservationist of Forest Hills, Rego Park, among other neighborhoods. I founded Rego-Forest Conservation Council in 2006 in response to the 100th anniversary of Forest Hills and the parcel which became known as Rego Park in 1923. Landmark-worthy buildings and treasures of Forest Hills and Rego Park face a growing number of insensitive alterations and demolition. We seek to preserve and commemorate our architectural and cultural history by advocating for individual landmarks, interior landmarks, and historic districts, as well as state and national register of historic places and properties, and also by assisting property owners in the acquisition of funding to restore their properties. As a Forest Hills Times newspaper columnist in 2012, I take pride in featuring preservation and often underrepresented topic in local media. And preservation is my civic duty and religious calling. I conducted a PR campaign and petition drive in 2010 in response to the Forest Hills Tennis Stadium's potential sale to Congress. This contributed to its iconic stadium partial restoration and creative reuse in 2013 as a concert venue. I also assisted Rego Park Jewish Center and the First Presbyterian Church of Newtown in Elmhurst in the acquisition of national register status. Presently, I'm co-organizing concert fundraisers to help restore of the church. I found the Friends of the Richmond Theater and succeeded in obtaining individual landmark status. I also assisted in landmarking campaigns for Engine Company 305, Perlman Company 151 in Forest Hills, as well as the Forest Park Carousel and the Sunnyside Gardens Historic District. JD Bakery in Forest Hills offered a great slice of Americana, but when it started in 2009, I brokered a deal to have the renewed a neon sign salvaged and relocated. I founded committees and brokered deals to spare the Moonlight Diner in Soho and the Shining Diner in Chelsea from demolition, and respectively, they were transported on flatbed trucks to Wyoming and Alabama. I then earned the nickname of Dynamite. Forest Hills and Rego Park have numerous properties which fit the criteria for landmark status, but since 2005, the Landmark Preservation Commission rejected a number of properties for a public hearing. And despite its over 100-year history, current official landmarks in Forest Hills and Rego Park are the Remington Family Cemetery, designated back in 1981, on the Rickard Savings Bank exterior, designated in 2000, and the Forest Hills Firehouse facade, designated in 2012. I extend an invite to Mayor de Blasio and the Landmark Preservation Commission to see Forest Hills and Rego Park from our perspective at a walking tour and hopefully a series of meetings. Let's work collaboratively on a city official to constituent basis before experiencing any further architectural losses. And I extend great thanks and much gratitude to the Historic District Council for this true honor. And thank you very much, everybody.
Nice. Hey. got you real close up there.
Can you hear me? I'm back? Okay. Just
okay.
Testing out the